Hi folks, it's Willie, and in the second lab there is a question about the number of valence level electrons, and since there isn't a chemistry prerequisite for this course, it's very important to take a few minutes to talk about how you determine the number of valence level electrons for an atom. This is a handout that I found at the website you can see listed up in the corner, so I certainly want to give credit for that because I think it's a very nicely done resource. So you can see from reading the introduction that the valence electrons are the electrons in the outer shell of an atom. A way to think about the structure of an atom is that it's basically a solar system model where you have the nucleus in the center, and then in orbits surrounding the nucleus you have electrons. Now, that's not the true structure of an atom, but it works for teaching purposes. The key thing, as is mentioned in the next sentence, is the valence electrons are the ones involved in forming the bonds. So the numbers of valence level electrons are going to be crucially important, as is explained here, because it determines the number of bonds an atom will form. Okay, so let's look down at this how-to guide. For neutral atoms, remember atoms are electrically neutral, which means the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons. In looking at your periodic table, you'll see at the top what's referred to as a group number. And the elements on the far left is group number one. Then we have group number two. Then we're going to skip across because we're not going to involve other elements there. We have group number three, group number four, group number five, group number six, group number seven, and group number eight. Now, the group number tells you the number of valence electrons. But in this particular figure, I understand why the creator of the figure did this, but it's a little deceptive. If you look at the atomic number for hydrogen, it's one. That means it has one proton and one electron. If you look at the atomic number for helium, it's two. That means it has two electrons, and yet helium is in the noble gases. So why do they have helium in group eight? Helium doesn't have eight valence electrons. Helium has two valence electrons, but with the first shell or orbit with two electrons, that's the maximum number it holds. So it acts just like the other noble gases that are in this particular group, meaning they have eight electrons, eight valence electrons associated with them, which is associated with a special stability. So please don't get confused when you see helium in the group eight. Helium only has two valence electrons, but again, the first orbit can only hold two. So that means that it is acting from a stability perspective just like the other noble gases, which have eight, for example, neon. So if we look at this, how many valence electrons does boron have? It has three. How many additional electrons does an atom of boron need to become stable, meaning having the same number of valence electrons as neon, a noble gas? The answer would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how many does carbon have in terms of valence electrons? The answer is 4. How many more does it need to achieve the same stability as neon, the closest noble gas? The answer is 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you look at carbon bonding in the second simulation, which is building molecules, you'll notice that carbon as a molecule always has a total of 4 bonds around it. That's because it needs those additional 4 electrons achieved through sharing in order to have the stability of the noble gases. So I hope this resource is helpful for you in filling out the table on the build an atom simulation with regards to numbers of valence electrons.